This is just a terrific partnership between the ECUA and Escambia County. It illustrates the strong working relationship that we've been able to develop in the last few years. This is a huge facility, and it's going to be good for the entire region, not just the ECUA, not just the county, but the region. This is going to stretch all the way from Okaloosa County, possibly all the way over to Mobile. And it couldn't have happened if it hadn't been for the partnership that we've developed between the two agencies. The building as you see it is quite large. It's over 53,000 square feet under roof, and it's a tent. You know, it's more than a tent. It's actually hurricane rated, but I tell everybody that if we get a hurricane, you're gonna have to go in the tent to be safe. But it's a big structure. It has all kinds of special accommodations called surge protection, water provisions, and various other things like that. But it houses the recycling equipment that we have here today. This equipment will process approximately 40,000 tons of recycled materials a year. That's about 25 tons per hour. That's a big amount of materials that will be brought in here. It looks like this facility is going to be at or near its capacity the very day it opens. It's just that much in demand. We originally started to build this facility at 15 tons per hour, and we had so much demand for it from the whole region that we upsized that to 25 tons, and you can see really what's happened. This is a marvelous facility, and it will take the recyclables. We will be able to sort them, bale them, and sell them on the commodities market.
I would like to invite all of you to join Elvin McCorvey in our invocation, followed by Larry Walker, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Mr. McCorvey.
Thank you. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, and we thank you for all of the effort that went into bringing us to this point. We thank you for our executive director who had a vision to develop this facility here in Escambia County. And we thank you for the county and administrator and the county commissioners who supported this effort. And we thank you for all of the ECUA workers who have worked so hard to bring us to this point. And we ask you that you will guide us as we move forward and do the things that will be pleasing in your sight. These blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
I invite you to join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated.
Well, welcome to all of you. I'm sure that so many of you are glad that this day has finally arrived. It has been a long and winding road with quite a few potholes and an occasional detour along the way. Soon after I was appointed to the ECUA board back in 2004, I brought up the subject of recycling. It's sort of the arrogance of a newbie on any board or commission. You think no one has ever had an idea until you are appointed, and now you're there to enlighten those people with whom you serve. Dale Perkins, who can't be here today, quickly let me know that they had been talking about recycling for a decade. But the consensus in this community was that we were just not that progressive. People here would not sort and separate and recycle. Oh sure, the faithful few would go to the dumpsters, which were filled to brimming and overflowing every single week. And yet the thought was that most of the people in this community would not recycle. Then in 2007, the LEAP class took on recycling as their issue. They passed out blue bins at public events. They spoke to the ECUA board. They called and called and called. Then I started thinking about them and thought, these are young people. They don't represent the whole community. But then we started hearing from other voices. I got calls, as did Mr. McCorvey, as did Dr. Walker, as did Dale. And the voices were changing. I knew that we were at the tipping point one day. I was in the Capitol Rotunda and my cell phone rang. And I heard kind of a quaky voice, and she said, "This is Mrs. Bird." And she said, "Lois, I'm 94 years old, and I'm tired of schlepping my cans and bottles to the sheriff's substation every week. Will you please start recycling?" And so we did. In January 2009, customers signed on one by one and two by two, and the number grew exponentially, exceeding the capacity of our first contractor, who succumbed to a mountain of debris. It was ugly, and it was on the front page of the paper. And still, our customers continued to sign on, and we kept finding ways to meet the demand to reduce waste. At the end, we were taking our trash all the way to Montgomery, Alabama. Finally, this year, that contractor, too, fell victim to political pressures outside our control and closed. We were running out of options. But because of the leadership at the county and at ECUA, we were well into planning for this very day. With the opening of this facility, we will no longer be completely dependent on outside parties to process our recyclables. We will control our destiny. And we, each year, will snatch 40,000 tons of material that would have languished in that landfill in perpetuity and recycle it for future use. Today is a testament to the people of our community who embraced recycling and who wanted a greener world. To visionaries like Randy Rudd, who couldn't be here today because he's accepting another award, another environmental award, and to Pat Johnson, who were committed to a state-of-the-art but also cost-effective recycling operation. To Scott Luth and Jim Howes, to the leadership of our team of quarterbacks, Steve Sorrell and Jack Brown, and to the tenacious 10 members of the Board of County Commissioners and the ECUA board, who decided to bury all turf lines in the sand and to work together for a better community and a better future. This is an historic partnership. Thank you all for being here today to celebrate our combined efforts and the efforts of so many of the people who are here, whom I cannot mention. You have played a vital role in moving our community, our county, and our neighboring counties into the future. Please give yourselves a big hand. We would not have gotten here, by the way, without leadership in Tallahassee. The state of Florida set a goal of 75% recycling by the year 2020. It was very ambitious. With the opening of this facility, this will no longer be a pipe dream. Representative Clay Ingram was truly a partner in the success that we have today. He brokered coalitions behind the scenes, and I would like for him to speak for a moment. Clay?
Good morning. Thank you so much, Lois. So it wasn't that long ago, you know, if you go back in time 3 years, just like Lois just spelled out, that this didn't seem like it could ever happen, that the potential was there, but that we wouldn't be able to overcome the old demons that have haunted us to make this happen. But thanks to truly visionary leadership on the Board of County Commissioners, the ECUA board, men like Jack Brown, like Steve Sorrell, Randy Rudd, Pat Johnson, so many people that have already been mentioned, they came to the realization they could sit down man to man, person to person, look each other in the eye, and come to the realization that the only thing that matters at the end of the day is the ECUA ratepayer and the Escambia County taxpayer. If you're doing the right thing by those two people, and candidly, they're you know, largely the same individual people in many cases, but if you're doing the right thing by the ratepayer and the taxpayer, that we can do anything in our region. And so for that reason, because of that visionary leadership, we have this today, this facility that will stand as a monument to the way things can be done in our region, in our community going forward. And so it's a point of pride for me now, from now on, to look at this facility and realize that it truly stands as a monument to the way things can be done in the future. So from the bottom of my heart to everyone that we've talked about today, to the contractors and workers that made this happen, it's a thrill to see this here today, and it's a thrill to be a part of this historic and monumental day. Thank you so much for having me. God bless you.
And thank you for all that you do, Clay. A couple of years ago, Grover Robinson and I were dueling speakers at Downtown Rotary on the subject of recycling, and we quickly figured out we could do a lot more if we listened more and talked less and if we joined forces. So here to give the county perspective is Grover Robinson, Commission Chair.
Lois, thank you. Thank you all the board members of the ECUA for having us. We certainly are proud to host you here at the highest point in Escambia County, and we are thankful that this facility will keep us at least from breaking any new records and keep making that thing higher. But this is a great day for recycling in Escambia County. And more importantly, it is a great day to show what happens when governmental entities work together for the betterment of the people. I too, like Lois, was thinking back to when I first got elected in 2006. And I remember in 2008, meeting Steve, several of us over at the EOC, trying to figure out how we'd make it so that curbside recycling was going to be a reality. And very excited that we did. At the same time, we were flaring our natural gas out into, just flaring it right here off the field. We've since then have turned that into, we recapture it with Gulf Power and provide power to plenty of homes. So we're going to take out 70% of what you put in here and take it out for recyclables and do something with it. And whatever's left, we're going to put it into the landfill and we're going to turn it into electricity that's going to power homes. It is interesting to see how far we've come in 10 years in Escambia County. And that would not have been possible if Escambia County and the board and its direction under leadership of Pat Johnson, his department, and Jack Brown had not been willing to find ways to work with ECUA, Steve Sorrell, Lois, you, Vicki, Larry, and Elvin McCory. We've figured out a way to figure out how to work together, and that was perhaps more important than anything else that we did here. We now have a state-of-the-art facility here, not in Montgomery, not in somewhere else, but here in Escambia County, that will be here for our citizens into the future. So, all I can say at this point is how appreciative I am of what happens when we work together and the opportunities that we achieve. And just to simply say, this is a great day for Escambia County and this is a great day for recycling. Thank you for being here and making a part of it. Thank you, ECUA, for being a partner to make it happen. We certainly appreciate that and we look forward to doing great things for our citizens.
And thank you, Grover. Vicki Campbell was the latest ECUA member to the recycling binge, but she jumped in with both feet. She has been a tenacious champion of recycling, so I'm proud to introduce Vicki Campbell.
Thank you. I am honored here today to represent the Citizens Advisory Council because, to me, the most important people in Escambia County are its citizens. Today is a great day for the citizens of Escambia County. Progress is never easy, and this has not been an easy task for Escambia County or ECUA. My hat's off to the staff members of both the Board of County Commissioners and the ECUA, especially Pat Johnson and Randy Rudd. For the first time in over 20 years, we are in charge of our own destiny for recycling. No third-party processor to run away when commodities dip. We're doing the right thing for the right reasons, and we're not done yet. There's a reason this facility is called Interim, because you can actually recycle 95% of what's in the green can. The citizens of Escambia County have voiced their desire for us to move forward with recycling, and I'm happy to tell the citizens that we are listening. Thank you.
Well, our boards are only as strong as our leaders. We take the applause, but we leave it to people like Steve and Jack to do the real hard work, to spend hours meeting and canoodling and figuring out ways to overcome the politics and everything else. So I would like to recognize first Steve Sorrell to say a few words, Executive Director of the ECUA.
Thank you, Lois. It's a little bit warmer. I'd take my coat off. I told Jack to take his off, and he said, no, he's the son of a preacher. He can't take his off, so he's going to stay on. First off, the partnership that we've been able to develop between the ECUA and the county. It's a true cooperative environment now. We're working on so many different things. We have the compost facility up and running. Just won a national award and won the state award for that operation. It's brand new. Jack helped with that. The county helped with that. Now we've got this facility. We're also working on Interrarity Island. So it just goes on and on and on. So we've got a great relationship that we didn't have in the past, and a lot of things good are gonna happen for the citizens of Escambia County. A lot of recognition needs to take place here today. I'm gonna get my list out so I don't forget to recognize some of the people who helped in the construction of this. Brown Construction, Lee, you're here somewhere. I saw you stand up. Lee did all the site civil work when it was just pure dirt. When we had nothing but pure dirt out here and asphalt, we let the contractor have this built. Lee's group, Brown Construction, came in and they actually did the site civil work and all the construction. The design, pretty elaborate design if you might want to take a look around. It's something you probably won't see anywhere else. You can probably put a couple of B-52s under here. Site design, Baskerville Donovan. Freddie, Keith, stand up, wherever the rest of you are at. Freddie's in the back, Keith's somewhere, and the fly keeps getting it. Anybody else from BDI, stand up. Nobody wants to. There's one, two more, three. Everybody with a red shirt's BDI. The building you're in here, made by Big Top. We went out to competitive proposals and we obtained the building from them. They were the lowest and best at the time, and you just take a look around, it's a pretty nice facility. It's pretty elaborate. I mean, there's some things here that you don't see. There's a special fire suppression system. There's a special lightning suppression system. Every single cross member is tied in. It's got little antennas on top. So don't grab a hold of one of the supports when it's lightning. But anyway, there's a ground loop all the way around this building. If it gets hit by lightning, it's going to take it around and right straight to ground. So it's a lot of special things we did. The big equipment behind me, the recycling equipment, bulk handling systems. Bulk handling, stand up. When we get the equipment actually running, which is going to be very, very soon, I didn't want it running today because of safety and noise, actually. But basically, when we get it running, we're going to have it operated by a company called Zero Waste. Zero Waste, stand up. Then the actual building construction was by Scalise Construction, and the electrical was by Kelson. If anybody's here from either one, feel free to stand up. They may not be here. There we go. I'm going to give you a little bit of history. I can't hear you, sir. The history is in 2009, the ECUA started recycling. Today we have about 67% of our customers who are actually voluntarily participating. We have about 100,000 customers, so that'll give you a pretty good idea. It's very, very large. We collect somewhere around 18,000 tons or so of recyclables a year, maybe a little more, so it's a big number. And basically, we started that in 2009. We had a partnership with a company called West Florida Recycling. They went under, filed bankruptcy. We had to help FDEP clean up the site. We hauled materials to Atlanta for a while, and the transportation costs got too high. Then we partnered with a company out of Montgomery, and they went basically under also. They're in lawsuits right now with the city of Montgomery. And our board decided, that's enough. Enough is enough. Let's do it ourselves. Let's bring it local. Let's make this thing happen. So we did, and this is what you see here today. This particular facility, it's going to process 40,000 tons a year. That's a big number. Okay, that's 25 tons an hour. And right where you're sitting will be the tipping floor. They'll actually bring it in and tip it, and we'll take a push wall and we'll dump it in the machines and go behind me, and it'll take and sort out the cardboard, and then it'll sort out the paper, then it'll sort out the glass, and we do take glass, a lot of other places don't. Then it'll sort out the metals, and then we'll bale it at the end, and Zero Waste will sell that on the commodities market. It's not going to be a major profit-making enterprise, but we're thinking that it's going to pay for itself. It's going to take all the materials that are being buried in the landfill. It's going to recycle those. To give you one idea, one of the aluminum cans, every can that we recycle will save 80% of the energy it takes to make one of those. So it's well worth having. We owe a lot of thanks to a number of people, and I'm not going to go on and on, but there are some people behind the scenes that did a lot of work. I mean, certainly all these people up here made a lot of the decisions, and the ECUA board gave me the authority to be able to build this. We took this facility that you see here now from dirt. We permitted it, designed it, funded it, and constructed it in less than 9 months. That's almost unheard of for a government operation. And look what you've got. The building is over 53,000 square feet, and it's hurricane rated. We'll process the materials that I told you about. So it'll all come here, and it's a win-win for us in the county, and we work on that partnership I was telling you about. Because what happens is there will be some what they call residue from the materials, and those materials will come out of this facility and go directly to the landfill, Pat Johnson's landfill. And there's a savings there, because we'll be able to use off-road equipment for that. We won't have to get actually road-worthy equipment that's been inspected and so on. We'll just take off-road equipment and take it to the landfill. The materials will be bundled. Okay, and bailed, and we'll sell those on the commodities market. Right now, the commodities market's pretty good. At one time, it's been about a year ago, it was pretty low price. Even then, it would probably pay for itself, but right now, they're escalating. The Chinese economy has a major impact on that, and right now, it's not doing real well, but we're still doing okay. I mean, we still think that this facility right here will pay for itself, pay the debt service, and keep everything going to the landfill that can be recycled. Now I need a little bit of thanks to a couple of people here. County people. Pat Johnson, stand up. Brent Snyder, stand up. Jim House, stand up. These are our county counterparts who did so much, and we couldn't have done it without them. Jack Brown, my counterpart, he's with the county, and I couldn't have done anything if it hadn't been for Jack Brown. He's great. Every time I need something, I call him. Every time he needs something, he calls me, and we just work it out. That helped a great deal. From the ECUA, we have a number of people who did a lot of work here. Randy Rudd, my deputy, one of my deputies anyway, he knows more about solid waste than I'll ever know. One smart guy. He's off right now collecting another national award for our compost operation that we just started. We won the state award for that. Now we've won the public sector private award, or public sector award for that operation. And now, I was told Friday, we even won the private sector award, gold award. So we're winning awards, and we're going to submit this one next year. So I wouldn't be surprised if this one wins something too, but we'll see. But Randy Rudd was huge in this. Bill Johnson, our director of engineering, I think Bill's here somewhere. Stand up, Bill. Oh, he's in the back waving his hand. Ned McMath, technical expert. I don't know if he's here or not. Steve Holcomb, he was our project manager. He knows more about projects than I'll ever know. All these people played a huge, huge role and made this happen. So I'm here to tell you that this facility is going to be in operation very, very soon. We're starting the test and calibration operation probably next week or so. So it is ready to go, and all the materials we're collecting is going to be processed. Thank you.
And now our county administrator, who has been such a vital part of this partnership, Jack Brown.
It's a pleasure to be with you today. First, I want to Big Top did not stand up, and I would be remiss if I did not have all the great people from Big Top stand up who created this facility. Big Top, please stand up. You know, as Steve mentioned, my dad was a minister, and he told me, be brief, be bright, be gone. The mind cannot take in more than the sea can endure. And I do want to say, though, it's two great organizations working together, Pat Johnson and Jim and Brent and their entire team have an award-winning, nationally recognized landfill here in Escambia County that is second to none. And partnering with ECUA, with their great facility, their great staff, Steve, is worked out leveraging our resources for the good of the entire public. I do want to acknowledge the Board of County Commissioners who, without their support, we couldn't have moved this project forward. When I first came on board, there was some hard feelings between ECUA and our board, and my entire board said, look, we want to figure out a way to work together for the public good. Steve has been a great partner, as the entire ECUA board. We really appreciate it, and this is, as Steve said, only the start of many great things to come for our community, leveraging our combined resources. Thank you.
Before we close, I just have a couple of other recognitions. We have, at the ECUA level, a Citizens Advisory Board, and Vicki is a very wonderful chairman of that group. But these people vet all of our ideas and discuss them thoroughly before these things come to our board. So I know a number of the people are here. Will the members of our CAC please stand? And we have a couple of awards to give out in commemoration of this day, but just before we do, I do want to mention the people who are on the podium. This is an election year, and ultimately when things go wrong, the people who are up here are the ones who take the heat if the recycling fails, if rates go up. So I want to take a moment and recognize them. Mr. Elvin McCorvey, who represents District 3. Dr. Larry Walker, who is District 5. Vicki Campbell, who is District 1. Representative Clay Ingram from the state of Florida. Commission Chairman Grover Robinson. Commissioner Stephen Berry, who has been chair during part of this, District 5. Lumen May and Doug Underhill are not here today, but they have certainly been a part of this. Wilson Robertson. Wilson has the unique experience of having served on both of these boards, so he truly gets it. And Representative Mike Hill. And now we have a little commemoration of this day because it was football season coming. We'd like something for each of us to have in our lobbies. And if Natalie will bring them forward. Steve and Jack, if you will come up. We take the applause, but these guys lead the workers who make this happen. And so, in recognition, these are the MVP awards.
Doug Underhill is here.
Oh, okay. And I understand that Doug Underhill is here. Hi, Doug. Thank you for coming. I want to add my thanks to all of the contractors, all of the staff members, everybody who brought us here today. It is a banner day in Escambia County, Florida. Now, go cool off and have some snacks and we'll all mingle. Thank you again for coming.